Hi there, Dr.Mungli here. So in this video, I will be briefly explaining about glycolipids. Let me explain you the blood group substances. Now the blood group substance, it is basically a glycolipid which contains a ceramide. So ceramide is a lipid part of blood group substance, and then we have attached with the carbohydrate. So carbohydrate portion of the blood group substance. So the basic structure, it will be N-acetylgalactosamine, galactose and fucose. Now the additional modification can go on to this basic structure that can give rise to different types of blood groups. So this particular structure here, this is the glycolipid here. So this entire thing, we refer it as H substance. So H substance is nothing but it is a ceramide, which is a lipid part of blood group substance. We have carbohydrate, that is N-acetylgalactosamine, galactose and fucose. Now we have a A blood group. So different types of blood groups. We have A blood group, we have B blood group, then we have AB blood group, and then we have O blood group. Now let's see what kind of carbohydrate antigen is present over each of these blood group types. Now the H substance is common in all the types of blood groups. All red blood cells will have H substance. Yeah, of course, other cells will also have H substance, but we use red blood cells to detect different types of blood groups. Now, person like A blood group person, so basically they will have H substance, and additionally through that H substance there will be addition of N-acetylgalactosamine, that is GALNAC. N-acetylgalactosamine will be attached to that galactose. So H substance with the N-acetylgalactosamine, it is basically type A antigen. So this that particular red blood cell means a person having type A antigen. This is a type A antigen with N-acetylgalactosamine added to its substance. So that particular person belongs to type A blood group person. So since type A antigen is present here in all the red blood cells, that means they don't have anti-A antibody. So they don't have anti-A antibody, but they will be, these people will have anti-B antibody. Okay, so in their plasma. Now coming to the B and blood group type. So B blood group person, so they will have H substance. Along with H substance, they just have galactose being added there. Now who is going to add galactose to this H substance? There is an enzyme called galactosyl transferase. So the galactosyl transferase is responsible for addition of galactose, making B antigen there. And similar to that, like A antigen, so I have told you N-acetylgalactosamine was added, and that is done by an enzyme called N-acetylgalactosamine transferase enzyme. Now, this is the B antigen here, because galactose is added to that substance, so the person has B blood group. Now, AB blood group person. AB blood group person, their RBCs, they will have both A antigen and B antigen. So it's a mixture of both the things. So that is why they belong to AB type of blood group. So that means they will have, their genes will express both galactosyl transferase and N-acetylgalactosamine transferase. Both the genes are expressed here. So it means they will have both the enzymes. That means they have A antigen, that is H substance with N-acetylgalactosamine. And also they will have B antigen, that is H substance with only galactose. So they will have both the antigen on their red blood cell. Now we're coming to the O blood group type. O blood group person, they don't have any of these antigen, like they don't have A antigen, they don't have B antigen. Basically they will have H substance on their red blood cells. So that kind of person, they just belong to O type of blood group. It means O type of blood group person, so they don't have any antigen, A antigen or B antigen over the surface. So that is why they will express both anti-A antibody and anti-B antibody in their serum. Why they will express both anti-A and anti-B antibodies in their serum, although they don't have antigen A and antigen B? This is because there will be similar carbohydrate antigens will be secreted by the intestinal bacteria. So this intestinal bacteria has the fermentation process, so they are going to synthesize and secrete similar type of antigen, that is A antigen and B antigen, and they will get into our body and our body will respond to that because it's a foreign antigen. and we are going to produce antibodies against it. That's why if you look at the all the four types of blood groups here, so A blood group person will have A antigen. So I'll write the antigen here. So antigen and the antibody. So A blood group person will have A antigen. So antigen will be A antigen, whereas the antibody will be B antibody will be present in that. Then the B blood group person will have B antigen on the red blood cell surface, but will have anti-A antibody. Why they will have anti-A antibody? Because the similar carbohydrate antigen to antigen A, it will be coming from intestinal bacteria. Although they have antigen B on the red blood cells, so that will be considered as self, and our body do not produce any antibodies against the B antigen in B person. So whereas the B antigen A, antibodies will be produced against the antigen A, which is the similar antigen, carbohydrate antigen coming from the bacteria. Coming with the AB person. AB person will have both antigen A and antigen B there. Whereas the antibody, they don't have any antibodies. Coming with the O person do not have any antigen A or antigen B there, but they will have anti-A antibody and anti-B antibody. So they will have both the antibodies. Now coming with this. O blood group person, especially O negative blood group person, so they will act as a universal donor of red blood cells. Why? Because they don't have any antigen on their red blood cells. So they will act as a universal donor of red blood cells. Now the AB person do not have any antibody in their serum. So that is why they can donate their serum or plasma to anyone, because that is a universal plasma donor. So AB blood group will act as a universal plasma donor. So AB person will act as a universal plasma donor, so it means they can donate plasma to anyone or any type of blood group. Whereas type O blood group person, he or she can donate RBCs to anyone, especially type O negative blood group person. Okay. So, this is all about carbohydrate antigen that is present over red blood cell, which is basically a lipid molecule, glycolipid molecule, so which is acting as an example for a glycolipid for us. This is all about glycolipids. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, so feel free to drop it in the comment section below. I'll answer to it as quickly as possible. Thanks again, and see you in my next video.